Great Britain are the men's team pursuit champions, setting a new world record in the process. The team pursuit pits two teams against each other on opposite sides of the track. The team posting the fastest time over 4 kilometres are victorious. In the race against Australia for gold, Great Britain dominated. Their team of Ed Clancy, Geraint Thomas, Stephen Burke and Peter Kenno got off to the strongest start and they never relinquished their lead. Their time of 3 minutes 51.659 setting a new world record in a faultless display. Australia finished 2.9 seconds behind. Taking the bronze medal was New Zealand, having beaten Russia earlier in the race for third. So the bronze medal was awarded to New Zealand. Australia claimed the silver, and the men's team pursuit gold medal was awarded to the team of Great Britain in front of a delirious home crowd.
It's a great feeling. It's been a long time coming, like boys said just now. We've been talking about it since November. This is all we've been thinking about. You know, every day we've got up with this day in mind. You know, we've been counting down the weeks from 10 weeks out, you know. It's just been a lot of hard work, and for it all to come off on the day, it's just unbelievable, really. You don't really think about this moment. It's all about the racing, crossing that line, and you don't even think about how you're going to feel or, you know, or what you're going to do. And it's just incredible, really. Yeah, there's a lot of hard work gone into this. Yeah.
And with all that work that's gone in, how does it feel at the start of a race like that?
You literally spend two or three weeks in your hotel room with sweaty palms just thinking about it and going over the same thing again in your mind. And like, the only conversation we've had for the last 3 or 4 days is just team pursuit. We just can't think about anything else. And we always sort of believed it was doable, but just to go through the motions and make it happen, it's just indescribable how it feels. You know, as soon as you cross the line, you realise it has actually happened and you've done it. And the talk's over, the whole thing's gone, and on to the next one, yeah.
Can you afford to think about the team that you're facing in the middle of a race like that, or is it about your own performance?
Yeah, to be honest, you can stand here and say, nah, it's not about the other team, it's just what we do, but the Aussies are the only, that's all we've talked about for the last year. You know, what are they going to do, what are the Aussies doing, trying to get out of our coaches, but ultimately it just comes down to what you can do, so you can think about it all you want, but at the end of the day, yeah, it's just what you go out there and do yourself, so you can't let it stress you out too much.
And then when that final gun goes, what's the feeling there?
Relief, first thing, you know, because, I just really want to win gold. You know, I wouldn't have been happy with silver or bronze, to be honest, but, it was all or nothing. And I'm just glad everything worked out the way we want it to.
I was completely shattered at the end of that, so I knew we gave everything we could give, so just got beaten by a better team on a day, I guess. So, yeah, it's a bit of a shame. We've come here to win, and we've worked towards this for the last 4 years, but like I said, we got beaten by a better team, and exceptional team. They did a 51. It's amazing to be here as it is, and to be in the presence of a team like that as well.
It's pretty awesome. I mean, for three of us, me, Jesse and Mark, we're a bronze medal in Beijing as well, and we knew coming into this competition that it was going to be tough to make the gold medal ride with the Poms and the Australians so world class. But I mean, I think we can be pretty proud of ourselves. We took it to the Australians in the second round, gave ourselves every chance to make the gold medal ride, and then we just knew in the bronze medal ride we had to put it on the line.